Welcome to Eye Care Central. This video is on lacrimal syringing and probing. In this video, we will learn how to perform these procedures and we will also learn how to interpret the results of these procedures. We will start with lacrimal syringing. Lacrimal syringing is done in cases of suspected epiphora to rule out any blockage in the lacrimal drainage system. In case the drainage system is found to be blocked, lacrimal syringing helps us in identifying the site of blockage. Lacrimal syringing is done before various intraocular surgeries like cataract surgery or glaucoma surgery to rule out any undiagnosed block. We can also administer antibiotics and steroids into the lacrimal structures with the help of syringing, for example in patients after DCR surgery. Another indication of lacrimal syringing is DCG or dactylocystography, in which a dye is injected through the lacrimal punctum for imaging of the lacrimal drainage system. It is also done to flush and clean the lacrimal passages of debris in patients who complain of epiphora. Before proceeding further, we will quickly revise the anatomy of the lacrimal apparatus. The lacrimal apparatus can be divided into two parts, the secretory part and the drainage part. The secretory part consists of the main lacrimal gland and the accessory lacrimal glands. The tears produced by the secretory part spread onto the ocular surface to form the tear film, and then they are drained out of the eye via the drainage portion of the lacrimal apparatus. The drainage part consists of the lacrimal puncta, lacrimal canaliculi, common canaliculus, lacrimal sac, and the nasolacrimal duct, which ultimately opens into the inferior meatus of the nose. Watering of eyes can occur due to two reasons. Either there is overproduction of tears by the lacrimal glands, in that case the condition is known as hyperlacrimation, or there can be a blockage in the drainage system. In that scenario, there is impaired outflow, and that results in overflow of tears onto the face. This condition is known as epiphora. So in this video, the condition that we will be discussing is epiphora. So how do we do lacrimal syringing? We start by first of all washing our hands. Then the patient is positioned comfortably with his head supported either lying down on a pillow or on a reclined examination chair. There should be good lighting, either by a torch or by an overhead lamp. Make sure that you explain the procedure to the patient for good cooperation. We take saline in a 2 ml syringe and we attach a sterile lacrimal cannula to it. Lacrimal cannula can be either straight or curved. In lacrimal syringing, we prefer the curved cannula. First, we flush the cannula with some saline to ensure that it is not blocked. We put some anesthetic eye drops into the eye of the patient and some drops also directly over the punctum, and we wait for 30 seconds for the effect to come. We ask the patient to look in the upward and the outward direction. Then we pull down the lower lid and identify the lacrimal punctum. Punctum is present on the medial aspect of the lid. With the other hand, we use the nettle-shaped punctum dilator to dilate the lower punctum. This is the nettle-shaped punctum dilator. This facilitates the passage of the cannula and also provides temporary relief in cases of punctal stenosis. The punctum leads us to the lacrimal canaliculus. So there are two canaliculi, an upper canaliculus and a lower canaliculus. Each canaliculus has a vertical segment which is about 2 mm long and a horizontal segment which is about 8 mm long. The vertical segment and the horizontal segment are positioned at 90 degrees to each other. The junction of these two segments is known as the ampulla of the canaliculus. The punctum dilator is inserted vertically down for 2 mm, then it is rotated a few times and then it is gently taken out of the punctum. Then we take the syringe with the lacrimal cannula attached to it and we insert the tip of the cannula into the lower punctum vertically for about 2 mm. Then we pull the eyelid laterally. This straightens the ampulla and brings the horizontal and the vertical segments of the canaliculus in line with each other. The cannula is then directed horizontally in the nasal direction. The saline is slowly injected and the patient is asked if they can taste salty fluid at the back of their mouth. So what are the results we can get? If the patient says that he can taste the saline, it means that there is no obstruction to the passage of the fluid and the drainage system is anatomically patent. But this does not rule out a functional block, in which case the passage may be anatomically patent, but the patient still has epiphora because of lid laxity or the weakness of orbicularis muscle or due to many other causes. In that scenario, other tests like Jones dye test etc. are done. I will be posting another video on Jones dye test. In this one, we will restrict ourselves to syringing and probing. If the patient says that he cannot taste saline, it means that there is a blockage somewhere along the lacrimal passages. The block can be present at the level of the canaliculus or at the level of the common canaliculus or even the nasolacrimal duct. Suppose we inject saline into the lower canaliculus and the fluid regurgitates from the same punctum, that is the lower punctum in this case, it suggests a canalicular block. You can see it in the diagram here. The diagram shows a block in the lower canaliculus. This block does not allow the fluid to pass through and the fluid refluxes through the same punctum. To confirm our finding, we repeat the same procedure through the upper punctum and ask the patient again if he can taste salty fluid at the back of his mouth. If he says yes, it means that the rest of the system is patent and this confirms a block in the lower canaliculus. If the patient cannot taste fluid and there is reflux of fluid from the opposite punctum, it could mean either a common canalicular block or a nasolacrimal duct block. It is important to differentiate between the two because their treatments are entirely different. So first of all, the fluid that regurgitates in the case of a common canalicular block is clear fluid, while the fluid that regurgitates in NLD obstruction is mixed with mucopurulent substance that is present in the lacrimal sac. Another way to differentiate between a common canalicular block and a nasolacrimal duct obstruction is by doing probing. Probing is done using a Bowman's probe. It can also be done using a lacrimal cannula, but Bowman's probe is preferred because it is easy to handle and it comes in various different sizes. You can check the size of the probe, it is written on it here. The probe is inserted through the lower punctum again in the same direction as we insert the lacrimal cannula. First, it goes vertically downwards for about 2 mm and then the lower lid is pulled laterally, the probe is turned horizontally and then it is directed nasally in a gentle manner. In case of nasolacrimal duct blockage, a hard stop is encountered, while if the common canaliculus is blocked, a soft stop is felt. In nasolacrimal duct obstruction, this is the site of the blockage, which means that the rest of the passage proximal to it is clear. So when the probe is inserted, the probe hits the medial wall of the sac and the lacrimal bone. This is known as the hard stop because the probe hits the bone. That means that the probe reached the sac and touched its medial wall and there is no block at the level of the common canaliculus or the lower canaliculus. What you feel in a common canalicular block is a soft stop. A soft stop is felt as a spongy stop because in this situation, the probe cannot reach the lacrimal bone because of the blockage present in the common canaliculus. The probe presses the common canaliculus and the lateral wall of the sac against the medial wall of the sac and that feels like a spongy soft stop. Also, there is a medial shift in the position of the medial canthus because the probe drags the common canaliculus and the soft tissues along with it. There is no medial shift in the position of the medial canthus in case of NLD obstruction because the tissues don't get dragged along. We can get an idea about the location of the block by measuring the length of the probe that went into the canaliculus. Sometimes in soft stop, the block can also be present at the level of the lower canaliculus. One more situation that may also be encountered is a partial nasolacrimal duct block. In this situation, the patient can taste the saline, but there is also regurgitation of fluid from the upper punctum. This happens because lacrimal syringing is not a physiological situation. Here we are injecting fluid by some pressure, so it manages to pass through a partial block. But in a normal pressure condition, that is in a physiological situation, the fluid may not pass through. So in such a scenario where we suspect a partial NLD block, Jones dye test is done to confirm the block. The contraindication of syringing and probing are acute dacryocystitis or acute canaliculitis because irrigation and probing may cause iatrogenic injury to the structures because the sac wall is inflamed and friable and it can lead to further spread of infection. Also, the procedure in this situation would cause unnecessary pain and discomfort to the patient. Sometimes acute canaliculitis may also be due to the presence of stones. That condition is known as canalicular dacryolithiasis. If syringing is done in such cases, it may push the stones further deep into the canaliculus and their retrieval may become even more difficult. Complications of syringing and probing, they can cause iatrogenic infection if aseptic precautions are not followed by the person performing the procedure. Creation of false passage, it can happen if the instruments are sharp or if excessive force is applied or if the tissues are inflamed. So I hope this video helped you in better understanding of these topics. Please like it and share it with your friends and colleagues if you found it useful. And please subscribe to my channel to support free education. Thank you very much.